We all know that e-waste is the biggest trouble all over the world. Heaps of electronic gadgets, monitors, keyboards, computers, PCBs, and refrigerators, and so much of waste is piling up all over the world. And we all know the dangers of these chemical toxic substances. And we also know that developing countries are throwing this junk into the developing countries, making their lives miserable. Today, we have done a small experiment. Almost past 6 years, I have been working on this experiment, how to recycle our e-waste, commonly available e-waste in your house, in your office, into a completely useful thing. We all know that many of the plant species have got capability to utilize so many chemical agents, because most of the plants depends upon so many minerals and also heavy metal from the soil. They can sustain handling them very, very easily. For example, today, I'll show a small experiment. Now, this is a standard printed circuit board. There's so many capacitors, and this typical PCB with all spot welded from behind. And this is the biggest trouble for this world. Now, what we're going to do is, we're going to grow some plants in them and see after 1 to 2 years how effectively they utilize. And I'm taking this plastic bag. It's completely waterproof, because our whole purpose is not to leak out all these toxic substances into the Mother Earth. So to prevent soil erosion and soil pollution, I'm going to do this planting method. Now, I have put these PCBs in this water-sealed packet. Aim is whatever we are going to put inside, it should not come out and again seepage into the soil, because our whole purpose is avoiding these chemicals into the soil. Now I put 2-3 PCBs here. They're all waste lying in my garage. Now I'm going to put this is an ordinary 2 parts compost and 1 part garden soil and with little bit of sand. That means an ideal garden potting material for most plants to grow. I am just going to put this in this pocket. Now you can see clearly how this is a small garden pot made out of normal plastic paper. Now we are going to do a pot, one normal dicotyledon plant it is. It is a Ficus bengalensis, a common banyan tree. I have used many trees in this experiment. Today we are going to use this tree and let us see how it is going to use up all the e-waste materials in this. Now any ready to pot, you can take a plant like this. And this is it has got a nice root ball, and it's an ideal for e-waste management pot. Now what we're going to do, it can really recycle many of the e-waste products in these PCBs. Let us see how it works. So you take your e-waste pot and nicely put it in the center of your PCBs, and you take the soil and nicely you pour the whole soil till you make a complete pot. Mind it, it should not have any leakages. Your paper should not be torn. Our whole purpose is not to leak any material out of this bag. See, there are so many ways you can pot it, but I prefer first I seal it in this plastic bag, polythene bag, and then once this potting is ready, your plant is ready, and then I put it in a ordinary garden pot like this, and I can do that final little bit fixing, and this cover the whole thing, and your e-waste experiment is ready. Now you can see a very, very well grown, I don't say a plant, almost a tree in this printer. This is more than 5 years old. And last time when I took the plant out for repotting, absolutely not even a metal piece, completely used up.